Hey, what's up everyone? I'll tell you what's up. Space. And do you want to go there? Do you want to be an astronaut? You do. Well, today's your lucky day, or should I say, your lucky month, because for the fourth time in history, the European Space Agency are opening their doors for new astronauts. Applications open on Wednesday, and I'm going to tell you how to apply. I'm Dan, I'm a space doctor, and this is how you go to space. Okay, so key things. One, applications are open from the 31st of March to the 28th of May 2021. So if you're watching this in the future, you probably should have subscribed. Number two, this is the European Space Agency, or ESA. So applications need to be from a member state of the European Space Agency. That's all of these countries. But don't worry if you're American, NASA look for the same kind of candidate. And if you're from somewhere else, don't worry either, because space is the future and your country will definitely do it one day for sure. So let's talk about the kind of person that ESA are looking for. So who can apply? Well, anyone, as long as you're from one of those countries you mentioned earlier. Men or women, and age-wise, the average age of an astronaut is about 35, which means that we've had astronauts from their late 20s through to people in their 50s. So if you're around there, then you're probably in a good position. If you're a bit younger, no problem. You can maybe buck the trend. But if you're older than 50, on this occasion, I'm afraid that it's the end of the road for you. I'm sorry. What's it like to be up there? Well, I'm going to do videos about life in space and about space medicine over the next couple of weeks, so, you know, think about subscribing if you want to see them. But let's talk about that person again. Academically, you probably need to be pretty decent, a minimum of a master's degree in a useful topic like planetary science or engineering or medicine. So maybe not a PhD in Egyptian archaeology. You also need to have at least 3 years of experience under your belt, either working in the field or a lab or something like that. The more degrees and PhDs, the more impressive you might come across. Well, you need to be pretty fit, and we're going to come back to that in terms of medical stuff in a minute, but you do need to be happy breaking a sweat. You also need to be able to swim, because a lot of training is done underwater. You need to be okay with flight training, like going on the Vomit Comet, and you need to be able to drive. Crucially, you need to be the kind of person who can work in a team, even in stressful situations. And of course, you need to be able to keep calm under pressure. I mean, we've all seen Apollo 13, right?
Houston, we have a problem.
After that, general things. You need to be the kind of person who's motivated, who makes good decisions, and is okay being away from your friends and family for a really long period of time. You're also going to be an ambassador. So you'll come back and you'll be inspiring kids from all around the world. So, you know, don't be a dick. Oh, and you need to speak English. Other languages are a plus, especially Russian, but it's not necessary because you'll probably learn that on the job anyway. Now, I told you we'd come back to the medical stuff. You definitely need to be an above average human specimen. We're talking like the human version of M&S or Waitrose here, probably not Tesco's. Any prospective astronaut needs to have passed an aviation medical. That's one that means you're safe to fly. It looks at your medical history, your general health, your vision, your hearing, your heart, your lungs, your blood, and even your urine. If you have a physical disability, it's not the end of the road, but you still need to meet the level of the medical. If you want me to go into more detail about what the medical involves, just tell me in the comments and I'll do a video for that. Okay, so look, you passed the medical, great. Then you need to be free from disease. You need to not be an alcoholic or a drug addict, seems obvious. Also, all your joints need to move properly, although there are exceptions made for people with disabilities. You need to have 20/20 vision, either naturally or with glasses.
You didn't happen to see anything at all.
You can't have any psychiatric disorders, and you need to have the mental capacity to cope with life in space, i.e., you need to be pretty smart. As for fitness, well, you don't need to be an athlete or anything, but when you get tested, they're going to put you on a bike and a treadmill, so you do need to be fairly fit. You go to the ESA website after the 31st of March and just apply online. You'll answer a few questions, you'll upload your CV and a copy of your passport and also the medical, and you'll write a motivation letter. That is, why do you want to be an astronaut? Why are you so enthusiastic about it, and what makes you different from everybody else? This is one time when you cannot sell yourself short. Then there's going to be 6 stages over quite a long period of time, ranging from screening through to testing, all the way through to interviews with the guy at the very top of the space agency. And then you might be one of the very few people who get selected. And I mean that. There'll be a lot of applications, and frankly, just applying is amazing. And any stage, you should be immensely proud. But hopefully, right now, I'm talking to you, the next person who's going to go to space. Actually, what am I talking about? I'm going to apply, and I don't want the competition. Why? No, you know what? Don't apply. Dan, what are you doing, you idiot? Oh my God. That's it. So as I say, more space content coming in the next few weeks. So if you want to see it, hit the subscribe button and the like button and the comment buttons and all the buttons, really. You can even follow me on Instagram as well. Hope you enjoyed it, and you know what? I'll see you in space.